episode. Up we get, and up, please. Thank you. Okay. Very good.
Okay, beautiful.
Okay, now if you lift your knees up to your chest and try and wiggle
further back, yes.
Yeah.
Better.
Yeah. Hold on, hold on.
Yeah. How fun.
Okay, we're good.
Beautiful.
Now let's see. Hopefully, we're going to stay up here.
Yeah.
I'm not too bad in the valet. The previous guy was 126 kg.
Yeah? Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Makes a big difference.
Yeah. It's all about wing loading, you know?
Yes. Are you a pilot as well?
I used to hold a guided pilot license.
Yeah.
Which I now call it
a SOAR.
Yep. GPL. Then I went off skydiving for a little bit. I soon learned that I preferred the ride.
Yes.
And then in 1987, when I was busy with the skydiving thing, the first paraglider arrived in South Africa.
Uh-huh.
That I'm aware of.
Yeah, right.
And started playing with that because they gave it to the skydiving. I was in the military at the time.
Okay.
And they gave it to the skydiving battalion that I was sport jumping under. And I was in the Air Force, that we could do sport jumping at the skydiving battalion. But I've been flying radio control.
Oh, really?
Riders, both scope and thermal, since I was 13. So it's all a natural progression.
Yeah, yeah.
I progressed quicker than a lot of people were comfortable with. But it was really just a case of learning a new flying machine in an environment that I was already very familiar with.
Yeah, for sure. My father...
Let's go back there.
My father had a sort of... did glider flying quite a bit. And so I never got up in the glider with him. Flew with him, and he had a private pilot's license as well. So flew in the.
It was kind of half the reason that I sort of wanted to go off in a gliding.
Yeah.
Because you can, you can get a good half of your flying hours towards your PPL.
Yeah.
In a glider or a microlight.
Yes, yeah.
And then you're basically doing power conversion. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to stay in the dynamic band here, the dynamic lift, so that thermals are coming along and then locking the arms for a while. And if they're not strong enough to lift us, then
yeah.
Critical components.
Yeah.
Well, you'd be good now.
GoPro evidence.
Yeah, that's a good to get some good angles here with your camera. Yeah. Keep it out the side. You can't drop it for 10 or anything.
Yeah. Somewhere different. It's wonderful. And we've traveled quite a bit with the children. Truly all over the world. Last year was Togo and Benin, West Africa.
Yeah.
But
how was that?
Once again, very different. We went days and days where we didn't see another white person at all, so you really stand out in the country. But just warm people, beautiful, exciting. Taught our kids, went to scuba diving, got them PADI certified in Oman a couple years ago. That was really, truly all over the world. And this is a part of the world we've never been.
If you're keen to head back to Africa someday, a leg of mine, his name is Andrew Payne, Malawian born.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Ghana.
Yeah.
You know, Colombians.
Yeah.
He has a dive resort on a small island in Lake Malawi.
Okay.
It's 5 kilometers from the Mozambique side.
Okay.
60 kilometers from the Malawi side.
Oh really?
Taking a year or two.
Wonderful.
And it's like, oh yeah. get in and mow, push mower or anything.
Right.
Just, you know, one of those, fuck it, I'm just going to land here.
Yeah.
And look kind of close to the ground. No person, you know, have a good time.
Yeah.
Drop it.
Yeah, really.
Really good.
Visited South Africa back in 2007,
uh-huh.
You know, Dick Kruger, sort of a, you know, animal safari thing. We really need to get back to South, the children I don't remember 2007.
It's very sad.
Yeah.
What happened. Just last week, I think, Friday, there was, I live in South Africa.
Okay. We did not get to Cape Town, but yeah, beautiful city.
I live in Half Bay, which is a tiny little enclave behind Cape Mountain. It's a little lake with the things in the bay.
Yeah.
A little fishing village and a fishing harbor. There was a Ukrainian businessman tourist. Murdered there last week. Just for his day pack.
Yeah, right.
There's a drug problem.
Yes.
And it's what we call tip. They basically what you call speed net, whatever.
Right.
We're gonna cruise in for a landing.
Okay.
And then we use the same approach that we did with the bigger guy.
Okay.
And around the back of the old toilets there.
Okay. Do I keep my feet up, or?
Let's see. I think we should be okay. Stand up. Yeah, stand up.
Okay.
There we go. Kind of my glider.
Yeah. Okay.
Good.
Yeah.
All right. Let's get a thumbs up from the grass level.
Of course.
Yeah. Thank you for flying. Sky Atlantida. Another 3 seconds and we're good.